Hey guys, welcome back again. So in this video we'll be implementing the delete feature, that is swipe to delete, inside our recycler view. So as we can see in the completed application, that if we swipe it to the left, then we can delete an item from our recycler view. So that's what we are going to do in this video. So let's go back to our application here, and here the first thing I would do is to go to our main activity, and we'll create a simple callback, and it should be item touch helper dot simple callback. It should be called simple callback. It equal to new item touch helper dot simple callback. And if you don't know how this item touch helper works, then you can watch my video that is linked above, where I've explained in detail each and every part of the simple callback. So here we need to pass in the directions. So firstly, we need to pass in 0 for the drag directions, and then we need to pass in the swipe directions. And here we are only targeting the swipe direction, that is left. So I'll only pass left here. It should be item touch helper dot left, like this. And then inside this on swipe block here, that is an on swipe method here, what I will do, I will check the direction here. So if direction equal to item touch helper dot left, then we want to delete the item. So let's lock out something here, or let's make a toast here that we are deleting something. So deleting, like this. And then what we want to do, we want to attach the simple callback to our recycler view which we have created. Inside this init recycler view, where we are initializing our recycler view, we want to attach the simple callback to our recycler view. So here I'll create a new item touch helper. So item touch helper equal to new item touch helper, and here we'll provide in the simple callback that we have created below, like this. And now what we'll do, we'll attach this item touch helper to a recycler view, like this. So item touch helper dot attach to recycler view, and here we pass in the recycler view, that is our recycler view, like this. So now let's run our application and let's see if it is working fine. So here if we swipe it, we see that it is working and we are getting delete, that is we are inside this on swipe block here, but we are not getting the background view here. So for that I'll be using a library. So let's go to this link here, where we have this recycler view swipe decorator by this guy called Zabaraz. So here let's copy its implementation from here, and let's go to our build.gradle file here, and here let's paste it here, and now let's click on sync. And if you don't know what I am doing, then you can watch my video that is linked above, where I have explained in detail about this library. So for this, let's go to the drawable folder here, and let's add in an icon for delete. So here I'll right click here and new vector asset. And now let me click on this thing here. And now let me search for delete. And let me click this icon here, and let me click on OK, and again next. And then let's click on finish. So we have this icon here, that is the IC delete icon. So now let me close the build.gradle file here. And now let's go to our main activity, and inside this simple callback we need to override one more method, and that is the onChildDraw method. So onChildDraw, and here we need to implement this thing here, that is from this library, to draw the canvas behind. So here I'm just going to copy this thing from here, and let me control C, and let's go back to Android Studio, and just before the super onDraw, let me paste it here. And let me include it by pressing Alt and Enter. And now let me also include the context compact. And here we need to pass in the background color. So for the background color of the swipe direction, so like this, as you can see here, that currently we are getting a white background, and in the completed application we see a pink background, that is the color accent of our application. So we want this color accent as a background view, and this delete icon here. So let's do that. So here we need to pass in the color, and the color would be the color accent, and the add action icon, and the icon would be r.drawable.delete icon that we have just created right now. And now if we run our application, so now if we delete, we'll be getting the background view. So now if we swipe it to the left, we see that we have a background color and a delete icon. And these rows are not removing from this recycler view because we have not implemented that feature till now. So let's do that. So here inside this onSwipe method, what I'll do, I'll get this view holder, that is this view holder, and I will cast it to my view holder, that is this note view holder, which we have created inside this notes recycler adapter class. That is inside this notes recycler adapter class, we have this note view holder. So let's cast this view holder to our notes view holder. So notes, note view holder, notes view holder equal to view holder. And now I will cast it by pressing Alt and Enter like this. And now what I'll do, I'll create a method inside this note view holder, that is delete item. So inside this note view holder class. So now let me create a public method here, that is public void delete item with no parameters here. And now let me call this method from this thing here, that is from this view note view holder. So note view holder dot delete item like this. So now let's go to this method here, that is a delete item method here. And here what I'll do, I'll just log something here. So log d get adapter position, simply just to know that which item we want to delete. Or what more we can do, we can also log in the snapshot which we want to delete. So log d plus get snapshots dot get snapshot, and the index would be again get adapter position like this. So now let's try to run this application and let's see if we are able to get that snapshot which we want to delete. Now let me clear out the console again, and now let's open our emulator and let's swipe it. So we see that we swiped it, and then we are inside this delete item, and it has an adapter position of 0, and the document snapshot is this snapshot. And now let me try deleting another document, that is this item. So let me swipe it, and now most probably we are getting item number 3, because 1, 2, 3, 4, because this is the fourth item and the index starts at 0, so this is the third item. So we are getting delete item 3, and the document snapshot is this snapshot. So now what we want to do, we want to create one more method inside this interface. We won't be deleting our item right away here, but instead we will be deleting our item inside the main activity by using the interface which we have created. So here what I'll do, I'll create one more method, that is public void handle delete item, and here we need to pass in the document snapshot like this. And from inside this method here, that is the delete item method, I would like to call this handle delete item. So note listener dot handle delete item, and here we need to pass in the snapshot, and we can get the snapshot very easily. So get snapshots dot get snapshot, and the index would be get adapter position. And now let me delete this log statements from here like this. And now we haven't implemented this handle delete item inside our main activity, so let's implement that. So let's go at the very top here, and here I'll press Alt and Enter, and it'll say to implement methods. So I'll click here, and we have to implement this method here, that is handle delete item. So let me press on OK here. So now we have this method here to delete the item. So now it is very simple to delete this item. What we can do, snapshot dot get reference dot delete, simply like this. And then if you want, you can attach the add on success listener. So add on success listener, new on success listener, and here we can simply log that what we have deleted. So log d on success item deleted, and that's all you need to do. So now let's try to run this application and let's see if we are able to delete the items from our recycler view and from our database itself. So now let me remove this item, that is watch Captain Marvel 2. So the item is deleted. And as you saw that we haven't notified our recycler view that the item row was removed. But as we saw in our application that the row was removed by itself. And that is again the feature of Firestore UI, because it is all handled by Firestore UI. And if we open our Firebase console here, we see that we no longer have that item, that is the watch Captain Marvel 2. And now let me delete this item here, that is watch Endgame. So let me delete it. So you see that this item was deleted. So this is how you delete items from your application. So now one more thing remains, and that is the undo feature. That is whenever you swipe to delete, Then you get a snack bar here which says that if you want to undo your operation, like in the current application or in the completed application, if I delete this item from here, so let me delete this item from here, we get this snack bar, and if I click on undo, our note was restored to our database and to our recycler view. So let's implement that feature. So that is very easy to do. So firstly, let's create a document reference of this snapshot. That is the snapshot we are passing here. So document reference equal to snapshot.getReference, like this. So now let's get our note from this document snapshot. So note equal to snapshot.toObjectClass. So our object class is node.class, like this. And now instead of using this thing here, that is snapshot.getReference.delete, what we can use, we can directly use a document reference here. So document reference.delete, and then finally, what you want to do, you want to show the snack bar. So snackbar.make, and here you need to pass in your recycler view. Second argument would be the text, that is item deleted. And the third argument would be the snack bar length. So snackbar.lengthLong. And then we want to add an action to this snack bar. So .setAction, and it should say undo. And now we want to handle this action. So new view on ClickListener. And finally, it should show, we should show this snack bar from .show. And now inside this undo method here, what we want to do, we want to set this note back to its original position, that is this note, back to this document reference. So what we can do, we can simply call this document reference dot set, and inside this set method here, we can directly pass in the note object, like this. And if you want, you can attach a success listener or a failure listener, but now I'm not doing that, because I know the task would be completed at some point of time, and if it is failed, then I'm not handling that case. So let's run this application. And now let's also open our Firebase console here. And now let's target this field, that this note is to show that it is real time. So we are going to delete this note from here. So let me swipe it, and we get our snack bar, and let's click on undo. We get this snack bar back. And as we saw that the note was deleted and it was added again. So just watch this ID, that starts from V4G1. So if I delete this note, this whole document is deleted with this ID. And whenever we restore this document back, this complete document is restored to this document ID itself. We are not creating a new document. We are restoring the document to the same ID. So just watch again that this starts from V4G1. So let me delete it. And now let me click on undo. So we see that it has been restored to the same document reference, that is the same document ID. So this is how you delete your note and you undo deletion of your notes. So guys, that's all about this video. So if you like the video, do hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, do subscribe to my channel. If you want, you can support me on patreon.com. I'll provide a link in the description below. So thank you, bye-bye, tata, take care, and have a good day.